हेलो एवरीवन, मायसेल्फ जया अग्रवाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर पॉलिटिकल साइंस फ्रॉम एसपीसीजीसी अजमेर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द पॉलिटिकल व्यूज ऑफ प्लेटो। इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट हिज फेमस बुक द रिपब्लिक, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द आइडियल स्टेट एज डिस्क्राइब्ड बाय प्लेटो। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। In recent years, there have been doubts about Plato's seriousness in implementing the ideal state. Strauss considered the Republic as the greatest critic of idealism ever written. It was a satire written with the purpose of demonstrating the limits of what was politically feasible. This was because the ideal state was unrealistic and unrealizable, for the philosopher was not a natural ruler, and governing was thrust upon him in the larger interest of the community. Therefore, the Republic conveys the broadest and deepest analysis of political idealism ever made. So, political idealism is the most destructive of human passions, and The Republic is the greatest critic of political idealism ever written. The Republic serves to moderate the extreme passion for justice by showing the limits of what can be demanded and expected of the city. Next one is, Strauss and Bloom asserted that Plato did not show a relationship between the two aspects of justice, namely harmony and happiness. At least in the case of the philosopher ruler, there was no proof that ruling would promote the happiness of the philosopher ruler, and nor the at least in the case of philosopher ruler, there was no proof that ruling would promote the happiness of the philosopher ruler. Nor were there compelling and convincing reasons for the philosopher to renounce a life of contemplation and take to ruling. They challenged the traditional viewpoint of Barker and others, and which contended that the philosopher ruled out of a sense of duty to do good to others, and regarding the good of others as extended self-interest. Sabine, explaining further, pointed out that Plato made two fundamental assumptions which were interrelated. These were, first one is that government ought to be an art depending on exact knowledge, and second one is that society existed for the mutual satisfaction of needs by persons whose capacities supplement one another. While the first was intrinsic to human personality, the second referred to education and experience. In view of these two assumptions, Plato was convinced that if ruling was entrusted to experts who could be trained, then governance would be above all the demerits, and political leadership was both an art and a science. Good governance would confer a dynasty of political rulers who could meet every contingency rather than have occasional premiers of the people, and besides that, it would eliminate factionalism and petty groupism in politics. Ruling for Plato had to be in accordance with the true sense of molding and transforming the state and individuals in light of an absolute standard. Political philosophy had to prevent incompetence, and in public life, the philosopher's vision of the forms and good was a moralizing experience, and that explained their commitment to the ideal state of which they were the architects. It supplied the state with an active, probing, critical intelligence. For Plato, every individual had a social side. Besides ensuring his own good, a philosopher must also be useful to the society. For it was only within a society that an individual realized that his true self, the philosophers ruled in order to prevent victimization at the hands of inferior rulers. So that's all for today from my side. Thank you very much.